41 people died in a gun and bomb attack on Istanbul's Ataturk Airport last night. More than 230 were injured. Three attackers arrived in a taxi and began firing at the terminal entrance before blowing themselves up after police fired back. The Turkish Prime Minister said early signs pointed to so-called Islamic State, but no one has so far admitted the attack. Let's speak now to Kyle Orton, who's a Middle East analyst at the Henry Jackson Society. A very good evening to you, Kyle.
Good evening.
So Turkey, and especially Istanbul, have now been a victim of a series of terrorist attacks.
They have. It dates back to the start of the Islamic State's claim to be a caliphate, and they've been attacking into Turkey, often at Kurdish targets and increasingly at the government targets as the state comes under pressure.
Kurdish separatists have also been an issue in Turkey, though, haven't they?
Yes, they have. They've been attacking the military targets largely in the east of the country. They would not have attacked in an area like this where there are tourists and potential Americans, because their Syrian affiliate is getting a lot of American support at the moment, and it would damage that.
And of course, with Islamic State claims over acts like this, we don't know. People can just announce an affiliation for them and go and carry out attacks. And as an organisation as such, there isn't a lot of coherence a lot of the time, is there? Which makes it very difficult to guess, you know, who and where are going to attack next.
Yes, it does. The thing is that they also attacked Lebanon the day before, and that was clearly aimed at targets that had been targeting them inside Syria. Even when they aren't officially ISIS members, so they're not connected directly to the organization headquarters in Raqqa, this is still ISIS's strategic program. They are looking to activate sympathizers in Europe and elsewhere to attack the people who are trying to degrade their state.
And what does Turkey do now? What does the government there do to try to crack down on this? It's becoming a huge problem for tourism, which is one of their biggest industries.
It is. The estimates of the losses from tourism are anywhere from about a fifth to a half. It's quite an extraordinary loss. The government has no choice but to try and crack down, and they have wound up a load of cells in the east of the country especially. They're rounding up at the moment about one cell a week in Gaziantep, which is the big hub of the aid workers in the east of the country. But as they try and crack down, ISIS will activate plots against them, as it did with Brussels when it knew it was going to be caught, so it just carried out the plot early.
And diplomatically, is Turkey getting enough support from the West, do you think?
It's not really, because the crisis is Syria. And while that continues to burn, these attacks will carry on. And Turkey has a much more forward-leaning policy on that, which is to remove the Assad regime as a means of stabilizing the country, and the NATO alliance, particularly the United States, has no interest in doing that at the moment.
So are there fears that while its stance towards Syria remains the same, that it's going to continue to be a victim of terror attacks like this?
I think it's going to be a victim of terror attacks, whatever it does at this point. The Islamic State has a strategic depth in Turkey and an infrastructure inside the country that would be there now, no matter what Turkey decided to do.
Kyle, thanks for joining us. That was Kyle Orton there, a Middle East analyst at the Henry Jackson Society.